video. Now this is one of the most common questions I'm seeing all the time, a VPS for Java. What is that? Do I need it? Maybe I need a VPN. I need my computer. I have Mac. So I'm seeing this question a lot, and that's why I'm making this cool video for you. I hope it will help you. So yes, first of all, let's talk about it. So I make also a nice tutorial over here. Very invest in that. You can have a look. So basically, what is a VPS? VPS is a virtual private server in human world. It means just another computer you pay from him with the remote access. Sorry, it means like if I'm now with my computer, I can connect to another computer in server, in the farm service, you can call that, and I can do whatever I want with this computer. Okay, I can run Java, I can do other things, a lot of people use it for eBay and many, many stuff. And the idea why people use that, so basically two reasons. First, if I don't want my computer will work 24/7, okay, and I do want to do more things than Java, it's really heavy program, it takes a lot of RAM and all of that, so I will take a VPS. Also, the second question, the second reason, Java is not for Mac, okay? Java, it's only for Windows platform. Now, if you have Mac, I'm also going to speak about another solution for you. But yes, basically, you need a Windows system to run Java. It's also writing on the website. You can also check it and understand these kind of things. So you can also see it on Java website. Now, what is the VPS requirements or your computer for Java? Let's say you want to run Java on your computer. You only want to start. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maximum 10 accounts. You don't want to take a VPS. You don't want to spend more extra money, or you don't want to get into that. So after 10 accounts, this is the things you need. Windows Server 2012, so it can do it good. 4 GB of RAM, 2 cores of CPU, and 40 GB of the SSD. Sorry. SSD is really important because if you don't have that, your computer will be so slow and static all the time, and it's like so annoying. So please make sure to get this kind of things for Java. If you have more than 10 accounts, so the best would be to use the Pine, sorry, 2019 version, 6 GB of RAM and 5 core of CPU and 80 GB of SSD. Okay, then your Java will run much better and it will be very fun, like just to work on things and it's not stacking. Okay, when it's stuck, crazy. So, where to get the VPS? Sorry, not VPN. If you're asking yourself, what is VPS? VPN, sorry. So, VPN is a virtual private network. It's something else. You can also use that for automation, but basically, when you use VPS and you use proxy, so it's also emulate. This is like the main thing you need for your Java. You don't need like another network. You don't need to hide all of the network. You just need to hide your accounts in a place where you work from. Now, what I recommend for VPS? So basically, you have a lot of options. You have also free options. For example, AWS, Amazon, it's for free. You don't need to pay for that. But the disadvantage is extremely slow and it's extremely slow, basically. And you get it for free. Yes, you can do it whatever you like. But I don't know. I don't like this kind of things. If you have only one account, you can test it. But I think you can also use it for your own computer. Up to you. Now, if you want something on payment, so I do recommend on GreenClouds, okay? You will also add the link below GreenClouds, and they have customized VPS for Java. You can go to the website. Oh, they have now 40% recurring. That's good. Christmas, that's great. So Windows VPS, Java optimized VPS, you can check this option. And what I like over here, it's extremely easy. It's telling you what you need for which number of accounts. Is it recommended the starter package for 10 to 40 accounts on $26, advanced for 40 on 100 accounts 46, and 100 to 150 68. Now I do recommend to start with the advanced package because the starter is also too slow for my experience if you have like even 6 or 7 accounts, but of course it's up to you. You just need to go and order it now, and I also will have the discount for you to get 10% off with that. Okay, it's extremely easy. You can also choose the location. They have many great locations in Europe and Canada and United States, even Japan, and really cool Hong Kong. So just choose, I recommend to choose the closest country to your country, okay, or the city or the state in the US. You have London, Amsterdam, so please choose the one that's the closest for you, because it will help you when you will use a proxy to get better results and faster results. We don't get to this at this point. I just recommend you to choose the country that your clients are working from. That will be the best. So if your clients mostly from the United States, from Los Angeles, check that, or Miami. Okay, and then you will get all of the details. You will get your VPS. It will take like 1 or 2 hours to get it. You will also maybe need to send something that states that you are really who you are, like I said, like a passport or something like that. That's what you will need probably. And you can go to the checkout and just you can put here the code WHT. I will also add it over here. I think it's WHT. I found it online. Yeah, you get 10% off for every month. That's really cool. Okay, and then you will get the details. Now, which details you will get? You will get your IP of this computer. You will get the username and the password, like you have on your own Windows server. Okay, and then what you can do to connect it, you can just go to in English it's remote access. Okay, and you can connect, or if you want, you have an app to connect it. Sorry, an app that you can do that. I will show you also the app, 1 second. So how much it costs, we discuss about it. I recommend the $46, but of course it's up to you. Common question, if I have only 1 to 5 accounts in Java, do you still need a VPS? No, you don't have to use a VPS, even if 100 accounts or 200, you can run it on your own Windows, okay? Just there are disadvantages, you must have a computer working 24/7. Okay, I know also some people who bought some computer for that. I don't know if it's cheaper. I don't think so. I think it's the best to use VPS, but of course, up to you. This is what I do. Want to use a VPS like AWS? We discussed about it also. It's a bit slow. It's making crazy, but you can also test it out. It's for free. Okay. Does the VPS come with an IP? Can I use that? Yes, you can use it for your own accounts. A client accounts, it's better for G proxies. It depends. Okay, if your clients are from the US and the VPS from US, you can also use the same VPS IP and you can test it. Mostly, I use it for my own accounts. I run on a VPS IP, and it's like fan page, so I don't care about. But if it's my client's account, I mostly run them on 4G. How can I connect to the VPS for my Mac? So if you have a Mac, you can just download Microsoft Remote Access. It's for free. Okay, it will be over here, and then you can download that and then connect to your VPS. You have another option. I don't remember the name. I think it's called Bung something. So you can also install a Windows on your Mac. 1 second, I will find it. Bungle or something like that. I'm not too sure about the name of this app. So many people post about it for Mac, because you can get the VPS, but you have another option. I still think you need the VPS for that. I'm not a Mac user, as you can see. This is all Windows. Sorry. But I will put another option for Mac. I don't remember exactly what it was, but there's also one more solution for Mac. I will check it and I will put this on the description. And I think that's it, guys. This is the main things you need to know about the VPS. I hope it helped you. If I did manage to help you, so please like and subscribe to the channel, and also comment below. Tell me what did you choose, what are you using. If you have another recommendation, so please let me know. I'm always open to use better service and be better. Yeah, always to learn. So thanks a lot, guys, and have a great 2020. Bye bye.